Hello, I'm Noah Satern, and welcome to Movies in Minutes. The object of this show is to review one movie in 1 minute. Today, let's talk about some famous Oscar-winning movies. First up, let's go back all the way to the year 1939 with Gone with the Wind, based on the 1936 novel by Margaret Mitchell. Starring Vivien Leigh and Clark Gable, this film tells the story of Scarlett O'Hara, a rich Southern belle and her various husbands throughout the Civil War and its aftermath. This movie caused a sensation at the box office and was the highest grossing film of all time for 25 years. It was nominated for 11 Oscars and won 8, including Best Editing, Best Supporting Actress, Best Actress, Best Art Direction, and Best Picture. This movie was an incredible undertaking with a runtime clocking in at almost 4 hours long. When I think of Golden Age Hollywood movies, Gone with the Wind is one of the first things that comes to mind. What really makes this movie work is the on-screen chemistry between Vivien Leigh and Clark Gable. Whenever they are on screen together, the audience is in for a treat. It celebrates its 75th anniversary this year, and it stands the test of time and remains an incredible film to this day. Another movie that came out in 1939 was actually The Wizard of Oz, and we all know how that one turned out. Next movie. Now we fast forward to 1960 with Billy Wilder's The Apartment. Starring Jack Lemmon, Shirley MacLaine, and Fred McMurray, this film is about a man who tries to climb the corporate ladder by letting his bosses use his apartment for extramarital affairs, as weird as that might sound. But complications ensue when he has a romance of his own. This movie is nominated for 10 Oscars and won 5, including Best Directing, Best Original Screenplay, and Best Picture. Unlike Gone with the Wind, the majority of this movie takes place in one New York City apartment. The apartment is a smaller story and more about the characters and is a dialogue-based film. I like this film because of its memorable characters, great dialogue, and is an all-around great comedy. The best part of this movie for me has to be Jack Lemmon's performance as the main character, C.C. Baxter. He just lights up the screen and is hilarious every time we see him. In an interview in the years later, Fred McMurray, one of the stars of the film, actually was slapped by a fan because he was so disgusted by her character. Our next stop is 1972 with The Godfather, based on the 1969 novel by Mario Puzo, starring Marlon Brando and Al Pacino. This movie has etched itself into the American pop culture with its saga of the Corleone crime family. Its dark narrative of crime and murder makes it one of the most beloved movies of all time. Ironically, as beloved as this movie is today, it only won 3 Oscars out of its 10 nominations. It ended up winning Best Actor, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Best Picture. However, Marlon Brando did not even show up to the ceremony to accept his Best Actor award because he was boycotting the awards that year. What I really enjoy about this movie is the general mood and engaging story that stays with you until the very end. It goes along at its own leisurely pace and out of nowhere has shocking moments of violence. It gives the audience an offer they just can't refuse. It also had many other great lines in the film, such as, "Take the gun, but leave the cannoli," which is probably one of the more famous improvised lines in the movie. Another one of my favorites is, "Keep your friends close, but your enemies closer." Next movie. Lastly, let's go to 1991 with The Silence of the Lambs, based on the 1988 novel by Thomas Harris, starring Anthony Hopkins and Jodie Foster. It tells the frightening, creepy tale of an FBI agent trying to catch a serial killer while getting help from another serial killer who was already behind bars. This film was also responsible for introducing to the world one of the most disturbing yet at the same time fascinating movie villains of all time in Dr. Hannibal the Cannibal Lecter. Unlike The Godfather, this movie etched itself into American nightmares. It also scared its way into 7 nominations and won what's called the Big 5. Best Actor, Best Actress, Best Director, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Best Picture. This is the only horror movie to ever win Best Picture. The only other horror movie to be nominated for Best Picture was The Exorcist in 1973. This movie is incredible for its dark and moody atmosphere, constantly twisting and turning story, and of course the phenomenal performances of Anthony Hopkins and Jodie Foster. If there's any movie that just sticks with you because of its sheer creepiness, it has to be this one. I chose these movies to represent the variety of different Oscar winners. It just goes to show that you can never really tell what's going to win until the envelope is opened. I'm Noah Satern, and thanks for watching this edition of Movies in Minutes. See you next time.